It was vaccination day at school, and Peter was terrified of it. Now, vaccines provide protection against disease-causing microorganisms such as bacteria and virus. Now, did you know that germs provide protection against germs? Yes, this is because vaccination is the introduction of any kind of dead or weakened germs into the body to develop a resistance against it. So weakened bacteria or virus or bacterial toxins are injected into our body so that a resistance is developed in the body against them. Now, why so? Just like all of us are extremely scared of final examinations, and to do well, we keep giving small unit tests throughout the year. Similarly, vaccination is the introduction of weakened germs so that we can fight against more dangerous germs when it infects our body in future. So, bacteria, virus in the weakened form and bacterial toxins are injected into our body. See, these are the weakened bacteria and virus, and these are the toxins that are injected into the body, and the body develops a resistance against them by producing antibodies or antitoxins. This entire process of providing protection to the body is known as immunization. Now, resistance developed by an individual due to a previous infection is known as active immunity. By that, I mean, suppose this person had been infected by a disease some 2 years back. So, his body has developed antibodies and antitoxins against these microorganisms. Now, these antibodies stay in the body. So, when the same disease-causing microorganisms try and affect the body the second time, these antibodies form a resistance against them and prevent it from entering or invading the body, causing the disease. Now, immunity provided to an individual not by his own body, but from an outside source such as ready-made antibodies is known as passive immunity. This happens in the case of a snake bite. Now, if a person gets bitten by a snake, then ready-made antitoxin injections are injected into his body. Now, how is this antitoxin made? Well, snake venom is injected into an animal that does not show any effect of the snake venom. We do not inject snake venom into human bodies because most of the times these snake venoms are highly poisonous and might be fatal for the human beings. So now, just like when any diseases or any weakened germs and toxins are injected into the body, antibodies and antitoxins are produced in the body to provide a resistance. Similarly, the horse's body also form antibodies and antitoxins against the snake venom that has been injected into its body. Now, the doctors collect the blood of this horse, and then the blood is separated into serum and clotted blood. That is blood that contains fibrinogen in it. So this part of the blood, that is serum, that does not contain any fibrinogen, contains these antitoxins against the snake venom that is used for passive immunization of human beings.